Dr. Trufan, and in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how we can precipitate the calcium from the calcium chloride solution that we created from mixing the chalk with the 1 molar hydrochloric acid solution. So for this experiment, we're going to start where we left off last time. And that is, here we have our calcium chloride solution, and it is the filtrate in our filtration setup. We're going to transfer this into a larger beaker. So I'm going to use a 250 milliliter beaker for this process. Next, we're going to precipitate it with something. So I am going to use my previously prepared saturated sodium carbonate solution. I will need to know the volume of sodium carbonate solution I'm using. So I am going to need a 50 milliliter graduated cylinder for that. Because I'm going to do a filtration, I need a large enough filtration setup, and I will use vacuum filtration today. Here is my clean and dry Buchner flask and Buchner funnel, and I will need a suitable filter paper for that. Once I complete the filtration, I will need to dry my filter paper with the solid residue on top. So I will need a source of heat, and that will be my hot plate. And I will need to remove the filter paper with a spatula, and I will need to contain it on a watch glass. Once it is dry, I will need to weigh it. So for that, I will need a scale and a weighing boat. So let's get started. For the first step, we need to transfer our calcium chloride solution into its new home, the 250 milliliter beaker. So we remove the used funnel, transfer the solution into it. Now you can always use the same funnel, but in between filtrations, you need to clean them thoroughly. Next, we're going to add a very small amount of deionized water. Swirl it really well and transfer it over. And we do this at least one more time. And with that, I am done with this and I can go clean it up. The next step is the precipitation. For that, I'm going to use my calcium chloride solution that I made, and I'm going to use 30 milliliters of the saturated sodium carbonate solution. You can always use a little more. I am using 31.0 milliliters of the saturated sodium carbonate solution today. So, slowly, we're going to start the addition. We can use a spatula to stir it. And we can feel a very thick precipitate forming. We can let it settle for a little bit, or we can move to the filtration right away. To set up for the vacuum filtration, I will need my vacuum flask, the Buchner funnel with the connecting piece, a clean filter paper that covers all the holes, and then I will need to connect to the vacuum line through a rubber hose. When making the connection, I want to make sure that the paper is stuck to the funnel, so I will use a small amount of deionized water to get that tight seal. And if we hear some funny noises, we just need to push down a little bit more. Next, we can move on to the filtration. When there is very little liquid on top, we can always add a little bit of deionized water into the beaker to make sure that our transfer is complete. And if I used a spatula for stirring, I need to keep the spatula in there until I'm done with the filtration. And with two rinses, I will consider my beaker as clean as I could get it. Now for the rest of the time, I need to wait until all the water goes through. Well, not really water. All my solution goes through the water with the dissolved soluble salts. On top of it, we should collect only the calcium carbonate. And then, to complete the experiment, we need to rinse at least once or twice with the ionized water to remove all the soluble impurities from our calcium carbonate solid on top. Usually a good sign for the filtration being complete is when the drops of water stop dripping. That may take a little bit longer. But what we are looking for is on the filter paper for the calcium carbonate layer to start cracking and show signs of dehydration. My filtration is now complete. I will disconnect and turn off my vacuum. And for the next step, I will prep myself for extracting the filter paper and drying it on a hot plate. For this process, I will need to turn on the hot plate, place a watch glass on top, get my spatula, scrape the sides of the funnel, and transfer my solid onto the filter paper. Then from there, I will gently scoop up the filter paper and transfer it onto the watch glass. And yes, it is a little bit moist, and if we give it some time, even at room temperature on the countertop, this will dry a little bit more. Or we can gently scrape it onto the top of the watch glass and have it dry then. But the rest is just waiting until our calcium carbonate on top of the filter paper dries along with the paper. It has been about 10 minutes or so, and I had my heat set a little too high, and so my paper got a little scorched, but that is okay because the calcium carbonate does not decompose at the boiling point of water. And at this point, we're simply removing the water that is still stuck to the filter paper and in the pores or along the pores of the calcium carbonate. So the next thing for us is to turn off the hot plate, remove the watch glass, and prepare to record the mass of the calcium carbonate that we collected. For that measurement, we're going to bring back our scale, turn it on, place our weighing boat on top, and then remove a filter paper that is of identical shape and size to the one that we used for the filtration of the calcium carbonate. We place it in the weighing boat, and then we tear it. When it shows 0.00, we remove the filter paper. Then remove the filter paper from the watch glass and place it on the weighing boat. The difference between the two measurements that is now presented on the scale is 2.44 grams, which means that of the original 2.95 grams of chalk that I started with, 2.44 grams were calcium carbonate that I was able to recollect at the end of a series of filtrations and transfer processes.